Good evening, and welcome to the Spring Edina High School Orchestra Concert. We've had a big year, and there is a lot to celebrate about our students this spring. Don't they sound great? It's just fantastic to play in this hall and get out and do a concert. The first piece you heard was American Landscape by Soon-Hee Newbold. She is a composer with a penchant for musical color, and we have enjoyed exploring the physical techniques that are required to make her colorful compositions come alive. In this piece specifically, it was the brushed stroke, which is a really complex technique that was fun for me to teach, and maybe a little less fun, but still fun for them to learn. We're going to dial things back about 300 years to perform a work by Antonio Vivaldi, his Concerto Grosso in D minor. We're lucky to have several students in Repertory Orchestra who served as wonderful leaders this year, primarily through their playing. You'll see students featured tonight who don't necessarily sit in the front row, but they've been steadfast members of our ensemble who look for ways to improve and lift others up through their playing. And this piece gives us a chance to feature just five of them. There are more, there are many, many students who were leaders, but this piece focuses on five students who will have the challenge of playing a solo part in this piece. You'll hear some back and forth conversation-like passages between the soloists, and they'll even trade ideas with the orchestra at one point in the piece. This is a very mature, complex work for ninth grade students to take on, and they've done a wonderful job stepping up to the challenge. Here's Vivaldi's Concerto Grosso in D minor. Thank you. Our last piece tonight is named Jubilant Overture. It's a joyous way to celebrate the end of our year together. I'm so proud of this ninth grade orchestra, and I hope that they will decide to carry their enthusiasm for growth and community forward into our program next year. I really can't wait to see where they'll go. And it's just each class going into it has been a wonderful place of joy and learning, and that's what we hope, right, all the way from 9th through 12th grade, that same feeling will be here. So we end the program for all of Repertory Orchestra with joy with this piece, Jubilant Overture.
Thank you.
Well, we have a short transition going on here. Is this on? No? While we have a short transition going on here, I'm going to take a second to talk about our next piece. We have a smaller ensemble coming up here taken of Repertory Orchestra students because you will be, in a second, the first people in the world ever to hear our next piece of music. It is a world premiere written by one of our very own students, Yuna Adhikari. Yuna is a ninth grade violinist in our Repertory Orchestra, and it came to my attention one day that he was a composer. He told me that he was in the process of writing a piece for violin and string orchestra, and I told him that if he finished the piece, and if it was the right difficulty level for our students, I would consider having us perform it at the spring concert. Composing a piece of music is really hard work. It's not enough to pour your emotions onto the page. You need to be able to refine those feelings and create a clean, legible score for musicians to perform off of. Everything's got to be lined up. The rhythms need to be written in a clear way. The formatting needs to be legible. And I'm very proud of Yuna for his patience because there's a lengthy revision process for any piece of music that I kind of put him through, and he did really, really well with that. So you're in for a real treat. He's written a very mature, introspective work, and he's eager to come share it with you. Do you have anything to share, or should we jump in? Let's do it. Would you welcome Yuna to perform the first movement of his violin concerto?
Thank you, everybody. Thanks. We're going to do a quick changeover. Chamber Orchestra, come on down here. But come on, just one more cheer for Yuna. Come on, just one more. Bravo. Violin concerto in F sharp minor. Every string player loves that. Give us 1 second to be get set, and then we'll continue. Thank you, everybody. This is the Chamber Orchestra up here. My name is Nick Gaudette, and I'm the director of the 10th, 11th, and 12th grade orchestras here. You'll see Sinfonia and Varsity pretty soon here. Chamber Orchestra is an extracurricular ensemble that meets on Friday mornings, sometimes Thursday, depending on the week. And we've been having a lot of fun hanging out this year, talking about polyrhythms and stuff like that. Actually, we've got some fantastic polyrhythms that we've learned. John, what are some great polyrhythms that we've done this year that we've explored? What does a 1-1 polyrhythm look like, John? Bravo. Just so good. Well, that's one against one. How about one against two? So polyrhythms are rhythms that are stacked on top of each other, and I just got to be honest, these kids up here, they crack me up every single time I come into the orchestra room, and they are doing the funniest music-related things that I just lose it, and I'm so thankful to have the time to be a music nerd alongside them all. So, like from the concerto in F sharp minor to the 1-1-2 polyrhythms, we're really excited to play a couple tunes for you today. This first one that we're gonna play is called Nemo's Waltz. It actually comes from a famous Nintendo game called Little Nemo the Dream Maker. And I don't know if anybody here is familiar with that game. It's a lot of fun. It's not Little Nemo, so it's not about a fish. It's about a kid that goes into dreamland, if you can imagine that. And then the second one that we have is a Simon Jeffs piece, Perpetuum Mobile, that is really cool. It's made for a small ensemble. It's actually made to play in the round. I hope you enjoy it. So this is the Edina High School Chamber Orchestra.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. Sinfonia, why don't you come on up and get set? Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. So first off, I wanted to mention real quick the group before here is Sinfonia Orchestra. That piece that they played, Angelina Baker, it's actually a favorite fiddle tune of mine from in the past. And when we learned that, we actually didn't use any sheet music at all. So they actually learned it all by ear, and then we created the arrangement. So that was a really fun project for us to do after the Mark Wood experience. If you look around the orchestra, some people might be wearing different outfits, different style outfits even from the rest of the group. And what that is that's a long-standing tradition where we allow our seniors who are going to be graduating and going on to other things to wear a prom outfit that they might have worn in the past. And so that's what you're seeing right here. So real quick, even if you're not wearing an outfit, that's okay, but seniors, can you stand? Can you stand real quick, seniors? Yeah. This is the Resilient Batch. Now, we celebrated at our banquet, which is fantastic, and we celebrated our seniors then, but I just wanted to say, seniors, thank you so much. It's been a great year. So we've got a combined orchestra piece, Sinfonia and Varsity together playing the Leyden Serenade. So I hope you enjoy. We're going to do one more transition real quick. As Sinfonia leaves the stage, thank you, Sinfonia Orchestra. Varsity Orchestra has one more for everybody. So just real quickly, wanted to thank you for coming to our spring and final concert. Students, don't forget, this is the last time playing, so we will be emptying lockers next week, which is super exciting. Hang on a second, students, quietly transition, please. Thank you. If you're looking for more orchestra concerts, there's still one more concert tomorrow night. Tomorrow night, there's a free concert at the Centennial Lakes Pavilion. It is called Coachella. It is Concert Orchestra's final performance. As you can see, Concert Orchestra's not up here on stage with us today. But they do small curated student ensembles followed by a few larger orchestra ensembles. So if you're hanging out tomorrow around Centennial Lakes, please come check out Coachella. So just a real quick shout out to Noah, who's running lights for us today. A quick shout out to Annika, who's running our sound, who's helping with our sound. A shout out to Pamela, who is our site host. She's our official EHS site host for the evening. Thank you to the custodials, thank you to Jack, thank you to the students and parents. Thank you for the energy that you've invested in your children so that I have a job. I just want to give a quick shout out to, once you're an orchestra parent, you're always an orchestra parent. My dad is in the audience tonight checking this out, so he's come to so many of my shows. I'm so thankful that he's here supporting me. And I hope someday you'll still be able to go to your children's orchestra concerts when they take that on as a full profession. So, thank you, everybody. Our last piece here is Molly on the Shore.